Remember when Jeff Bezos called out his tech rivals for not stepping up to the plate when the country needs protecting?
My view is, if big tech is going to turn their backs on the Department of Defense, this country is in trouble. This is how we're going to do it. We are going to support the Department of Defense. This country is important.
The Silicon Valley tech giants love to walk hand in hand with the Pentagon, but their employees not so much. Google workers protested a program using artificial intelligence for drones. And Microsoft employees have voiced their concerns about a $10 billion contract with the Pentagon to offer cloud services. But lucky enough for the Department of Defense, Amazon, led by Jeff Bezos, America's richest man, has stepped up to the plate. They say Amazon is happy to do business with the Pentagon.
We are going to continue to support the DoD. This is a great country, and it does need to be defended.
So it turns out that when Amazon didn't get that contract and Microsoft got it instead, Bezos was angry. He took it to court, citing bias from Donald Trump.
The preservation of public confidence in the nation's procurement process requires discovery and supplementation of the administrative record, particularly in light of President Trump's order to screw Amazon. The question is whether the President of the United States should be allowed to use the budget of the Department of Defense to pursue his own personal and political ends.
But the irony is that Jeff Bezos, with his legal action, has double-crossed the very same entity he swore to protect. As a result of the lawsuit, the entire program, which the Pentagon says is necessary for national security, has been put on hold. The military brass is unhappy.
We are disappointed in the ruling and believe the actions taken in this litigation have unnecessarily delayed implementing Department of Defense's modernization strategy and deprived our warfighters of a set of capabilities they urgently need.
The U.S. Department of Defense says it will lose $5 to $7 million every month the program is delayed.
Bezos changing his opinion in a way that serves his pocketbook is not necessarily, or may serve his pocketbook, is not particularly a surprise. I think there's a debate to be had on the degree to which these social media, tech companies, and search companies are able to assuage public opinion, change public opinion, restrict debate. These are big issues that I think, on the balance, when people think about it, there's going to be a drive, I believe, a populist drive, to lessen the power of big tech that cuts across the political spectrum.
Well, apparently, for the world's richest man, the country only needs national security protection when he's getting a share of the defense budget. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.